Hello, ladies and gentlemen, what is going on? It is me, T7 Gaming, here with another episode, and today we are actually going to try something very, very different. This episode is a pilot episode, if you've ever seen a pilot episode. This episode is the start of what I want to call Deep Talks on YouTube. And essentially, this will be a series where I take a given topic, something that's on my mind, or something trending, and talk about it. It's intended to give a perspective, a new look on something you may have only seen in one way. It's supposed to start academic debates. I will be speaking from experience, from statistics and facts, and from philosophy. All of this is 100% scripted by me. The Illuminati did not make me do this. So without further ado, let's get this started. So speaking of starts, while I was planning the series and thinking how to get my point across academically without offending a large majority of people, I was thinking, what's a good way to start a series meant to get the mind thinking? I didn't want to start with anything too deep, and I didn't want to go too simple. Then my friend suggested, who decides what simple is? I immediately hopped on that train of thought and asked myself follow-up questions, and the best one was, who decides where the start of something is? Let's take a circle, for example. Where is the start of that curvature? Is it where the pencil first made contact with the paper, or elsewhere? One could debate that it started at the pencil, and even farther back, where the graphite came from, and even farther back than that, and so on. Everything can go back infinitely. Greek philosopher Democritus had the same concept. There has to be a point where you can't cut the apple anymore. He called that the atom. Later on, though, it was discovered that the atom had smaller parts, electrons, neutrons, and protons. And even smaller than that, a quark, and that there is probably infinitely smaller pieces to an atom that we have not yet discovered. So where is the start if you trace it back far enough? Based on Merriam-Webster's dictionary, start is defined as to do the first part of something, to begin doing something. This does not say where the start is. It says what a start is. Let's go back to geometry. In geometry, you can find the start of a line by finding where it is on the coordinate plane. Using ordered pairs, you can find the start and end of a line. But in geometry class, I remember people struggled with the concept that lines can be infinite. They don't have a start or stop coordinate. So who dictates where that line's start is? Is it just the viewable grid that we have? We were told that it's infinite. Well, maybe infinity isn't a real thing. Maybe there is a limit to numbers. Maybe that limit is where the start or stop of the line is. But no one can dictate where the start of something is except for the creator. Going back to the circle, maybe it is where the person first touched their pencil to the paper. Maybe they decide it's somewhere else. It's too abstract of a concept if you put it in my way. Also, who decides the difference between abstract and simple? I've been told many times that what I think is too abstract for an answer. For example, in literary analyses, I've been told I try to make something simple too abstract. But who decides that what my opinion on the author's text is abstract? I find my claims simple and obvious. For example, when my English class was having a conversation on the book, The Lord of the Flies, I had a steadfast opinion that Ralph, the main character, was analogous to Hitler. Everyone in the class seemed to disagree with me, but they didn't know their history on the rise of Adolf Hitler as well as I did. Obviously, I didn't win this debate because the number game kicked in, but they didn't realize that Hitler was a good leader until he invaded Poland, and my teacher and many of my fellow peers had the audacity to tell me that my studies were wrong and that my claims were too abstract. What I don't understand is how my facts are considered abstract and how my analogy that worked and made sense at that point in the story is abstract. Sure, maybe other people saw it differently, maybe it was abstract, but just relative to them, I thought it was simple and obvious. But sadly, ladies and gentlemen, that's all the time I have to share my opinions on what defines start and what defines simple. If you enjoyed this episode, then leave a like. It would really mean a lot to me if this trial episode got lots of likes. It would show me that you would like to see more videos like this, and the more likes you leave, the more often you'll get them. As of right now, I plan to upload them once a month. Suggest topics I should talk about if you'd like to see more. Feel free to leave respectful critiques in the comments and respond to them with respect and delicacy. Thank you guys very much for watching. If you enjoyed, please leave a like. And if you would like to see more, then go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.